Oh, I just realized I was muted. Great. Yeah, I often forget to unmute myself. So unprofessional. Okay, so okay, in code section. Code section asserts code section. Well, it's not asserted. It's, symbol. Size team EDX symbol const EDX executable return return. Symbol address larger than code section symbol symbol return 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 in code section. So if in code section less index less symbol in code section. I wonder if we should perhaps. I think that's okay. Less index, less symbol in code section. Okay. So if. If not in code section, continue. If empty continue. If or not in code section, or not in code section, more symbol, more index. Okay, there we go. Okay, so basically now we have independence. Yeah, so it takes all the symbols and it checks if the symbol is actually in the code, in the code section. And if it is, then it takes it. Yeah, I think that is fine. Yeah, maybe we can do that. Then we can remove all this stuff here at the top. Okay, this would mean we can also put this back here. Let's get symbols. Size. Okay, and then we can comment out all this garbage here. All this garbage. Okay, I think that is maybe a little bit better. Yeah, maybe. Basically, we avoid building this vector, but on the other hand, we have now to iterate through all the symbols. Yeah, but it gives more flexibility because this then also works with, yeah, it's more universal. Address 0, that's weird. Address 0. I don't understand this accept list thingy. List symbols. Okay. Executable, yeah, more symbol. Okay, let's see how many matches we get now. So before we had 88 and now we have 91. Why do we have 3 more? That's unexpected. That really is unexpected. Okay, but now I see that our reserving is not good. Like, we are way over reserving. Yeah, maybe we just reserve. Just a number, a larger number, like 512, and then it just doubles from there. No, it just... Okay, good, then we have matches and match bundles. Let's do match bundles implementation next. Match bundles. All right, let's have a quick look at what we did so far. Oh, all right, let's remove all this. In code section. Okay, so match bundles. We need to match bundles. We need to match bundles. So, okay, so our PDB reader does give us information about compilants and source files. Okay, I think we need a new option here. So in our class, bundle types, match bundle types. Match bundles. Okay, so we need something like PDB compilant or PDB CPP. Yeah, and then there could also be other options like EXE something or. Match bundle types. Okay. Then let's do two. So two. Okay, two match bundle type. Const char none. Bundle type. Okay. So if str case compare 0 case compare. PDB compilant return PDB compilant else if PDB CPP return PDB CPP. Else return none. STR. STR. Okay. Okay, so if we go to function static assets execute pip. Here. Okay, so the idea here is that we have ASM compare options. We put a match bundle type. ASM function match. How about we call it match options, ASM match options, match bundle type. While at it, we should probably also give it a default egress. None. Actually, so CPP, PDB CPP. So config compile and CPP. File index. Bundle file index 0. Compilants. CPP. Okay, so basically we give it the bundle type, so either compilant or CPP. But then we also say which file index for bundling. The file that will be well, the file that will be used for bundling. For function bundling. Well, it's the file that will be used to group functions. With the method to group functions with. Or to group symbols with. The source file. Okay. Is a match options. Let's rename this to ASM match. Compare is not a bad name. Compare, but the other things are called function. Function compare. I don't know. Okay. Good. So we have now some information. If O dot bundle type, well, is compilant, then we do something else. If bundle type is CPP, oh, I can also do a switch case, maybe switch or bundle type case. Compilant break CPP case none default break. Okay, so if compilant, then how do we do it? So we have bundle type. If PDB readers, PDB readers. Let's do is if let's do if o dot file index for bundling smaller than 2, switch o bundle type if PDP readers. Let's rename this to bundle file index. I just don't want it to be so long. Bundle file index dot PDP readers. It's ready. Okay, in our PDB reader, we need to access compilers and source files. Using compilant info vector equals that. Source file info vector is that. PDB. Compilant. Okay. Then we need get exe info. I wonder if we should simply do here inline return mexe instead of putting it all into the CPP return m functions. Return m symbols and put that there. Compilants, source files, get compilants and get source files. Okay, then we can remove these three here. Okay, PDB reader. Okay, runner. So we say compilant, get compilants. We say get compilants. PDB compilant info vector, and of course it erases that compilant compilens const equals compilens if compilens.empty, not empty, then we continue. And we do the same here for the CPP. This is source file info vector compilants CPP. Sources get source files. If not sources empty, then go ahead. Okay, so another question is, how do we do this? GDP. Okay, so we have match bundles. Okay, I already see a problem. How? So basically, we need to loop through the source files, and then in the source files, we see the function IDs, right? But then we need to make the association we need to make an association between, oh boy. Yeah, this will be tricky. Well, we need a map, I think. We need a map, yeah. Okay. So here we string to index map. Function name to index function name to index. Function match name to index. All right. let's move this down here. Dot reserve 512. So we say here index t index equals m matches dot size function name to index dot no name match match name equals index. Okay, so we have a lookup now, that's good. Now we also need here compilant const pdb function info. Function info vector functions equals get functions. Same here. Okay, and then basically what we need to do is for compilant info, pdb compilant info, const compilants, compilant dot function IDs dot for vector index t index compilant function IDs. Oh boy. For compilant function match bundles dot mplace back match bundles dot reserve. Well, let's resize compilants dot size. Let's do for size ti equals 0. Match compile. Well, let's do size t index equals 0 plus plus index match bundles index index. Function edx compilant edx compilant. Okay, match bundles. Well, let's call it bundle edx dot name equals compilant dot name, and dot matches compilant equals compilants. Let's do compilant index for compilant index 0. Index t const compilant size equals compilant size compilant index smaller than compilant size plus compilant index. Then we remove this thing here. Compilant equals compilant index, and also p match bundle match bundles. Hold on, match bundles compilant index, compilant index, compilant name, compilant match bundles. Oh, what did I do here? Okay, match bundles, compilant index, match bundles, compilant name, bundle.name, bundle.matches. Function compilant, let's call this count instead of size, count, and here function count compilant dot function IDs dot size for function index equals 0. Function index smaller than function count plus function index. Oh boy. Matches dot resize function count. function con. And I think we need to make this a template function. Function index function and compilant bundle. Okay, so bundle matches function index. Oof. Function match name to index functions. Functions compile functions ID function index functions PDB function info function info const function info function info dot decorated name if no function function name to index function name to index dot find decorated name iterator IT boah, it's complicated. Let's put a little bit of spacing here to make it easier on the eyes. IT, I think here we assert IT is not, it cannot be end, I think. It should never be the case. So IT const iterator IT second bundle matches function index equals IT seconds. Oh boy. I think that's it though. It's quite a bit. It's quite a mouthful. Okay, let's see what compiles. Okay, let's see. Well, Didn't hit. Oh. Right. We started off with compilant. Let's put here compilant for starters. Okay, there we go. Okay, so we got functions, we got compilant, 32. Good. If compilant's not empty, compilant count, 32. Resize, 32. Compilant index, compilant, bundle, bundle. Yeah, function count 25, bundle name, resize, okay, and now we collect those. So we have functions, function IDs, function index, so this should be accessing 0, yeah, so this is this, okay. And the assert hits. Okay. Okay. Ah, because, because not everything will be a match. Yeah. Okay. Let's abort this. So, okay. Okay, I just realized there is a little bit of a problem here. So currently it will not tell us if either side something is missing. Like if we are missing. Yeah. So, okay, but it could be a separate step. So basically, our function match, we won't have any records for things that do not match. But maybe that should be a separate vector, like function no match. I need to think about this. Yeah. I'm probably maybe I'm thinking about use cases that are not so relevant yet. Like I'm thinking about like what happens if we have if we want to know like which functions are still missing in a certain file, right? Like so we have a CPP, we implemented a bunch of functions, but then we are still missing some functions which should be there, you know, and then this could tell us, this function is still missing. There is no record on one of the sides, right? Yeah, but let's think about this after we are done with this. Yeah. Okay, so if it is not end, then do this. Okay, so compile. Let's put here reserve. And here we put make a pushback. Pushback. Okay, let's try this. Okay. By the way, let me check how big is this actually? Oh, it's not so big. Could be worse. Okay, let's go back. Okay, so functions, compilants, count, okay, bundle, function count. Matches, reserve, bundle matches, reserve, function count, function info. Iterator, it didn't find this one. Didn't find this one. It tries. Well, this is a good opportunity here. Like if it's not found, then it's a good opportunity to like track this, that we have some function that we do not have a, did not find a symbol for else. Track. Unmatched functions. Okay, let's put a breakpoint here. It does hit, okay. So, win main. 18 matches. Okay, so match, hold on, matches 18. Win main, yeah, okay, good. Okay, this works. So it should hit a bunch of times, yeah. Okay, this is good. Yeah, and once we are done, let's see. Our bundle, match bundle 32. Okay, here we got all the compilants and we got our indices. Yeah. Okay, cool. Okay, I think this works. Yeah. Okay, I think we take a break now. I think this has been long enough. Yeah, 2 hours 40. So next step will be to move this into a template function so it can be used the same way for this. I think we can template this. Because source file, because source file info and compilant info, they have the same names for these things. So we just access name and function IDs and they are absolutely identical. So we can template this function. Yeah, this code here, we can template and then call the same down here and it should just work. Otherwise we would have to duplicate this code and it would do essentially the same thing, right? Okay, yeah, this will work. And then we have our match bundles. Okay, excellent. Good, then I will take a break here. I hope you enjoyed. The microphone was turned on for half the video, but you know, silent viewing that would be. All right, I wish you a great day or night. Until next time, goodbye.